trying to get my schedule changed, man. They got me running around and talking to this person and that person. I'm not trying to be in this bald-headed man class.
I'm not even bald.
You should have passed all your courses. The system is broken. The system is broken. The system is broken.
Well, systems are what scientists use to understand the world around us.
I was supposed to be in human anatomy so I could like dissect a frog or something, you know? Oh, I dissected a cat and a beetle pig, something. Whose class was that? Like, that's the class I'm trying to be in. Whose class was that? It wasn't here. I did it at home. I did it by myself. I don't want to do that. Are we going to do that in here?
No. Science is split into several disciplines. We have the formal sciences, life sciences, physical sciences, social sciences, and applied sciences. And there are several others, but we'll just talk about these. The formal sciences involve mathematics and logic. Life sciences include anything dealing with living things. So that's biology, human anatomy, botany, zoology courses. The physical sciences study non-living systems and how they interact with one another. Physics, chemistry, astronomy, geology. Then you have your social sciences. These sciences examine societies and the relationships among the individuals within those societies. So psychology, sociology, and economics, several others. And then your applied sciences use these other sciences to develop more practical applications of those other fields, like engineering, medicine, forensic science, and environmental science.
So you got stuck in a course that deals with non-living things? That's boring, man. Well, we got stuck in the course that's responsible for living things. Buddy, I see.
Oh, you understood the assignment, clearly. In physical science, you'll be learning about how things move.
How did you do that?
It's magic. Things move because of forces doing work on objects, because they required energy. And that energy can move from place to place through waves, allowing you to text while I'm talking. And that energy can also be converted into several forms, like electricity, which is the reason you can watch this video right now, or probably even see anything in this room. Most importantly, that energy is keeping the atoms of all matter together. You'll learn about the structure of those atoms, how they bond together to make all sorts of compounds necessary for life, how they're named, how they react with other compounds and important reactions that keep us alive, how they can react to convert great amounts of nuclear energy for good and bad reasons, how they change states to create clouds, rain, and even ice for your beverages, like the solution of coffee on my desk that I'm about to drink right now, which seems to be the only thing keeping me alive.
Okay, I get it. So essentially we're gonna be blowing things up. I'm either blowing something up or I'm cutting something up. There's nothing in between. I'm either blowing something up or I'm cutting. Hey, mama, come get me.
I need security to room 2665 right now. Security, please.